Hi there and welcome back. Today we are doing DIY wall hanging slash wreaths, whatever you'd like to call it. And I am using yarn I had on hand, some beads, and some faux florals that I tend to accumulate. In this first shot, what I'm doing is I'm just wrapping it simply around the form all the way. And you'll see in the next shot, because I pulled this so tight, it caused the frame to bow out a little bit, you see here, which really didn't matter once it was hanging on the wall. You can't really even see it. So if that happens, don't worry about it. This first knot I'm using here is just a simple macrame lark's head knot, and it's very easy to do. It's all over YouTube. You can find how to do it, but it's not that hard. And it's just a simple knot, but it looks really good and finished when you use it in a couple different ways. This is one of my favorite yarns. It's a chenille yarn from, I think, Joann's, and it was a while ago that I got it. You can find these on sale often, but it's so plush and pretty, and I thought the colors looked great with what I'm doing here. On this thick, chunky yarn that I'm using, what I did is I used just a little hot glue and made kind of a point out of it. In doing so, it just helps it look A, a little more finished, and B, it helps adhere to the form a little bit better. And I just glued this, I braided it, and I glued it all the way around the form. Just glued it all the way down. And then on the back, you'll see I went kind of back and forth to just give it a little bit more support, so it'll hold a little bit better. Now I just added a simple little loop on the back to hang it from, and that was it. I really had some difficulty though trying to figure out how to lay down the florals. Initially, my thought with this was really just the two colors, the pale blue chunky yarn and the beigey off-white yarn that you see here. But what wound up happening is that it did not look finished. It looked bare. And so then I had to play around with it, as we often do. And I came up with this idea, is to just add some eucalyptus that I had dried out from an arrangement I received. And then these, I'm not even sure what kind of florals these are, but I got them from Dollar Tree, and they were the color scheme I was going for. And I think in the end it turned out pretty for what I was trying to do. I'm not 100% sold on it, but it's growing on me. So here I decided to lay down some of the petals from the eucalyptus as sort of a base, and then once all the florals were on there, I added some more petals around it to cover any glue and also to make it look cohesive. And I thought that that also helped in kind of stabilizing the floral piece that I put on there. And I think it worked out well. After adding these gray pieces, I decided to not cut all of it, but to leave some in the center, angling down to a point. And I just really liked how all of this came together. And for the outside of the wreath, I just used some of those scraps again and cut some down to size. See, I actually even like that. But, you know, I was going for a certain look at this point. But the scraps that I use on the outside and more scraps of the string that I used, I decided to put that intermittently on the outside in between the gray string. And here's more scraps. And I really liked how that looked. And I didn't show a lot of this, but I wound up putting some beads that I had on hand on the top part of the ring and then on the string that hangs down, and you'll see in the shots at the end. And really, this is my favorite wreath. And I would love to know what your favorite wreath was out of this or what you might do differently. So thanks for watching, and I hope you look forward to the next video. Thanks.